I was just in L.A. I took my daughter to Disneyland and one of these nature sea park places, and they have these billboards all over, you know, come see fish in their natural habitat. And then you get there and they have clowns riding on the back of dolphins and whales jumping through fire hoops, like, this is what you see when you go to the ocean. And then you go to the snack bar and they serve fillet of fish. Who are these, the acts to fuck up? Yeah, that's a nice threat to have hanging over you. Look, you missed the hoop one more time. You see your friend Louis on the grill over there? Now, we're not fucking around. Get on the bike. I don't care if you're a fish. Get on a fucking bike, now. The bike or the grill, I'm not kidding. What is it with the animals with the bikes? I took my daughter to the circus. She said, Daddy, how do they teach a bear how to ride a bike? I said, it's easy. They nail his feet to the pedals and they beat the shit out of him. He's not riding, he's running. Just happens to be attached to the bike. She said, really? I said, no, all bears ride Schwinn's to the woods. Yeah, it comes natural for a bear to ride a two-wheeler. My daughter wanted a pet. I got her a goldfish. I thought that was the safest thing. Like, in one day, it was dead, and my wife goes, get rid of it. So I flush it down the toilet, because that's like the traditional burial at sea for fish. You can't do that with a dog or a cat. I mean, what if you did and it got stuck and the Roto-Rooter guy came? Yeah, I think I found the problem. You got a German Shepherd in your toilet. Can I use your phone for a minute? Then she wanted a rabbit. I got her a rabbit at like Easter time, and about 3 days later, it's acting real sick and it's just laying around. And my wife goes, gee, maybe we should take him to the vet. I said, yeah, why don't you just let me take him for a drive? I'm gonna take a $5 rabbit to the vet. Yeah. So we're at the vet. And the vet wants to put the rabbit in the animal hospital for observation. I'm not kidding. So we go to visit the rabbit like 2 days later, and it's in an oxygen tent with an IV in its arm. And the guy goes, I have some bad news for you. I said, yeah. Am I wearing an I'm an asshole t-shirt? Pull the plug now. I think we're looking at four potential keychains here, maybe. Then I got her a puppy, and you know, I love my wife, I really do, but I don't know why, but if the dog shits in the house, she asks the dog if he did it like he's gonna answer her. Have you ever seen somebody do this? She goes, get over here, did you shit over there? No, honey, Aunt Rose shit in the kitchen. She drags the dog over to show him the shit. See, I don't do that, because the dog already knows he's shit. You drag him over, they piss all the way over to the shit is. Just more mess for you to clean up. I got mad. I wanted to hit him. She said, no, you don't hit the dog. That's cruel. You rub his face in the shit. That's how you do it. I said, yeah. Let's ask him which one he wants. Rub his face in the shit. Good luck if it's a Rottweiler or a Doberman or something. Hey, did you shit over there? Yeah, you got a problem with that? No, it's a nice looking shit. Yeah, and on the rug, too, just the way I like it. But you need your balls polished while I'm here. My wife wanted a cat for a pet. She said, you know, cats are better than dogs. When a dog has to shit at 3 a.m, they wake you up, you gotta get up, let the dog out, wait till he's done, let him back in, go back to sleep. Cats, they have their own little box. They're so smart, you could actually teach them to go on the toilet. Yeah, great, when you have to go and the cat's in there. How long are you gonna be, huh? Fuck it, where's the box? And then you use the box and your friends come over and go, what do you got, a mountain lion for a pet here? Oh, he eats a lot. Yeah, you feed him corn? Isn't that weird that corn comes out like that? Why not just dump it right in the toilet and eliminate the middleman?